Good morning once again. You're still watching Urban Today. My name is Henry Sekanjako. We are going to be talking about the Ethiopia-Tigray conflict. This is an ongoing armed conflict that began in November, about 3 weeks ago, between the Tigray region, rather in the Tigray region of Ethiopia, between Tigray region special forces led by the Tigray People's Liberation Front, that's TPLF, and Ethiopian National Defense Forces, in alliance with Amhara Region Special Forces. And of course, during this conflict, many people have died. They've lost their lives. And over the weekend, we saw the Ethiopian government taking over the Tigray city, that's Mekelle. And of course, to discuss this, I've been joined by Vivian Kamsime. She's an expert on foreign matters. And we're going to be discussing this. Good morning, Vivian.
Good morning, Henry.
How are you today?
I'm very
How was happy. Your weekend?
My weekend was beautiful. I heard you guys saying that you had telephones in your during your secondary school.
Exactly, yeah. Well, I don't know how was this during your time?
I actually didn't have one.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow. So I was wondering.
And what do you think about that? If only government is saying that you know, students should be allowed to carry phones and all that in the schools.
The situation going on in Ethiopia is basically a situation of developing stories.
Okay.
There are a number of things going on, and any time from now, a number of things will be unfolding. Okay. The Ethiopian Prime Minister has declared that they now are controlling the Tigrayan region, and in a statement that he posted on Twitter, on his Twitter account, the Ethiopian army is actually manhunting the TPLF fighters who are hiding around the Tigrayan capital. What is interesting is that at the start of that announcement, there was no immediate response from the TPLF. But as time went by, the TPLF were able to disclose to some media agencies that they decided to leave the city before the arrival of the Ethiopian army, because okay. it would have been a very devastating situation for the civilians. So to avoid those
pair, and they're not telling us how many people have died.
Yes,
no one has come out with the figures yet to tell us this, you know, number of people.
Yes,
you know,
a number of international agencies keep saying about 100,000. About 100. Hundreds have died, but so far what we can confirm is that over 44,000 people have been displaced.
Okay.
And they've been displaced to neighboring countries like Sudan.
Okay.
But also within the displaced, the camps of displaced people within Tigray, over 100,000 people are now displaced. And the hospitals in Mekelle are now overwhelmed with the wounded. So it is not exactly a good situation going on there, but we know that.
Vivian, take us through quick facts about this conflict. Who are the Tigray people?
Now, the Tigray people are basically called the Tigrayan. And these people speak Tigrinya.
Okay.
Yes. And by the way, their region is also home to the Irob and Kunama people, so they are not the only ones occupying this region. And they have neighbors, of course, Djibouti, you earlier saw them up there. And Eritrea, one of the neighbors, is also a key neighbor, because they are somehow involved in this ongoing situation.
How are the numbers like, you know, Tigray people versus Ethiopians?
The Tigray people are actually 6 million people, and the Ethiopian population is about 110, meaning that the rest of the country totals to about 104 people. Yes.
And of course, one would imagine that the Tigrayans are part of Ethiopia.
Yes.
And you know, I would wonder, the viewers, people watching us would wonder, why are these people fighting themselves?
A number of reasons. There one being Mr. Museveni likes to, or General Museveni likes to use the word ideology.
Okay.
The major reason that could be causing this situation could be that Mr. Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed's ideology is different from that of the Tigrayan people. He basically believes in a unitary government. He believes that the country should be unified, increasing the federal government's power, mm-hmm. while the regional governments should have minimized autonomy. Mm-hmm. Now, the TPLF argues that the federal nature is much better for them to manage their country's ethnic differences. Mm. So they basically have those clashing ideologies, and mainly that's why we see what is going on right now. Also notable is the doings of the Prime Minister, Mr. Okay. Ahmed. Mm. What is happening is that this peace, this Nobel Peace Prize winner has been doing a number of things okay. that have led to this situation. For example, when he got this Peace Prize, he got it for his efforts in resolving the Eritrean conflict. We know that Tigray was very involved in this conflict, and they could have seen that as a move of actually him being in bed with their enemies. So definitely that had to be a bit of an issue for them.
Yeah.
Then when that happened, he went on to free a number of political prisoners who had been actually arrested by the previous regime, which was controlled by TPF.
Mm.
So that was also annoying on their side, and they actually did not like that. Yes, there's, like I said, a number of reasons. Also, Tigray is a very strategic region. It has a strategic importance in the running of Tigray. They mm-hmm. have been in power since mm-hmm. 1991, and when their prime minister died, Meles Zenawi, in 2012, the country went into some kind of unrest mm. because of the kind of rule that the TPLF was administering. They saw it as being engaged in system corruption and oppression, and that did not actually come off well with some of the citizenry. And that is how actually Prime Minister Abiy came into power. And as he came into power, the unrest looked at him as a symbol of hope.
Mm.
Now, as a symbol of hope, they had so many expectations from him, and he had these radical changes. They looked at him as a reformer and all those issues.
Ahmed is such a great fighter.
Yes.
Because I remember during this conflict, many foreign countries offered assistance.
Yes.
And he said, no, I think we can handle this as a country. And we've seen that over the weekend, the Ethiopian government, the military, took over Mekelle.
What is happening is that Mr. Abiy looks at this as basically a military operation, which mm. has, which is short-term, first of all, and has very achievable objectives. So he does not look at this as a long-term conflict
okay.
that can actually trickle down over the coming days.
Mm.
Yet we actually right now know, because of what is going on, that this is far from over. And as a matter of fact, we are expecting it to actually get worse before it can actually get better.
Okay.
Because while he was busy declaring the victory of having taken over Mekelle, the Tigrayan forces were actually also announcing that they had downed and captured a military pilot.
Okay.
So we can see that while they ran away from the capital, they are actually looking to do a kind of guerrilla war. They have run to the mountainous areas. While the Ethiopian army is looking for these fighters, the situation is still fragile.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. You're still watching Urban Today. The studio is Vivian Kamsime. We're talking about the conflict in Ethiopia, where the Ethiopian government was able to go to Mekelle. And the situation, I think it's now coming to normal, and we hope for the very best. We'll be bringing you these and more, of course, in a series of foreign news package. And of course, be sure to join us again tomorrow for this particular segment, where we'll be talking more about what's happening in Ethiopia. Right now, I think we'll take a break. We'll stop for a break. When we come back, we'll be talking about employment in Uganda. Keep it up, and we'll be right back.